G'day guys, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new here, I'm Jack from JM Exploring. Now today I'm going to run you through the gear I chose to take on our trip to most importantly run our Ingle full time and a few other 12 volt appliances that we chose to take on the trip with us. Now I'm going to run you through the pros and cons of the whole setup and what I would do differently if I was to do it all again. Now before we jump into the box up here, we'll jump under the bonnet and talk about the deep cycle that I'm running under there. So we'll jump under and get talking. Alrighty guys, under the bonnet we got a Bosch starter battery. It's a 125D31L and we got a M4 80 amp marine deep cycle and the model number for that is a DC27. Now I'm running a Red Arc 100 amp isolator in there as well just to make sure the cranking battery never goes flat and I can wake up in the morning and start the car no matter what. Now the deep cycle battery is there for emergency purposes, just a backup in case the AGM carks it and I can't run the fridge or the inverter. That'll get us through until we can go and replace the AGM battery. I only run the two-way off that. That's all I've got wired up at the moment and a wire going in so that I can swap all the appliances over and run it through the deep cycle. Now, the Bosch starter battery is an absolute machine of a battery. It cranks the engine over so well. I'm so happy with it. It's been 2 years and it's still performing like I bought it when it was new. I run the compressor off that and that's the only thing I run off that. I keep the car running when I do that so I can get that extra bit of power coming through. Nice and simple under here, nothing special. And I would highly recommend these Bosch batteries. Now we'll jump behind my seat and we'll get talking about the AGM battery setup. Alrighty guys, inside the car here behind my driver's seat we've got a 135 amp AGM battery which is powering our 400 watt Enerdrive Gen 2 inverter. And I've got a 60 amp circuit breaker in there just in case it short circuits or anything goes wrong, it clicks out there and takes the power away from there. The inverter is pretty good. A few weeks ago we did actually blow it up. I took it into Battery World where I bought it from brand new and they replaced it straight away, no questions asked. They don't know what was wrong with it and they said they'd never had that problem before, it just wasn't turning on. So they're going to get back to me on that and I will leave it in the description what actually went wrong with it. But the customer service they provided and replacing it instantly and even fitting it for me, that was incredibly awesome and got us on the road straight away. We use that every day with the laptop charger and we definitely needed that, so I'm extremely happy with that customer service. Of course we've got a 12 volt King's accessory box. Now King's gets a pretty bad rap for certain things, but this box seems to be doing pretty well. It allowed me to set it up myself. I actually did all the wiring myself and I'm very happy with it. I did it with a mate, a few beers, and we took our time and I learned so much and I would highly recommend doing it yourself because you learn so much and if something goes wrong I'm pretty confident I can fix it myself, so that was a huge plus side for me. Now the King's box has two Anderson plugs. I run the Travel Buddy off either of those Anderson plugs there, which is pretty cool. I got a volt reader there which definitely comes in handy and I got three 12 volt cigarette sockets, two USB chargers and five switches and a fuse box up there for every single socket and switch, which is awesome. Now the switches here, we got 1, 2, 3, run all our exterior lights. I got nothing on the last two there, just these three. I also ran wiring around to the top of the alu cab inside our bed there, so at night if I hear something outside or someone's snooping around I can switch all those lights on with three switches and hopefully it's going to scare them off. Hopefully. Now, as you can see up here, we've got a Red Arc BCDC 1225D smart charger. If you're gonna have an AGM or lithium battery, you're gonna require one of these smart chargers. Now, there's so many different brands out there starting from really cheap to really expensive. Red Arc's on the expensive side of it, but anything Red Arc seems to be very good quality and it is definitely proving itself at the moment. It allows me to have a solar panel on the roof. This Anderson plug here goes straight to the charger and this side of the Anderson plug is the solar panel on the roof. Now the reason I've got an Anderson plug there is because I can disconnect that Anderson and I can put a solar blanket on that Anderson plug and swap them around, because what we have found is when we get to camp we seem to be always looking for shade and of course when you're under the shade your solar panel's not getting the sun, so I opted for a solar blanket and now I can chase the sun when we get to camp and I don't have to worry about parking in the shade. And parking in the shade is much nicer than parking in the sun. Now of course when you're going for a smart charger make sure it's got the solar panel option there so that you can connect a solar panel, because not all of them have that option. But yeah, that's pretty much it with the box and the inverter and battery. What I would change, straight away, I'd rip that AGM battery out, that 40 kilo bloody piece of crap. I cheaped out on it. I didn't do my research. I rushed into it. It cost me $150 and I'm paying the price now. It doesn't last very long and I am having to start the car to get some charge in and swap to that deep cycle battery that I've got under the bonnet there. So definitely do your research and don't cheap out on what battery you're going with. I would put a lithium battery in there from the start. I'd lose that deep cycle under the bonnet and I'd probably be losing about 50, 55 kilos there. Secondly, the solar panel on the roof. Like I said, we're parking in the shade all the time. I wouldn't even bother with putting it on the roof. I'd just go with a solar blanket straight away. The only reason I'd have a solar panel on the roof would be if I'm parking up after work every day. When I go back to work, I'd have a solar panel on the roof just so I could run the ingle in the back. That's the only reason I'd have it. But right now, we're driving the car every day. We're going to different spots every day and we're looking for that shade. So solar blanket from the start. All in all, guys, we're pretty happy with the setup. With the exception of that AGM battery, of course. Considering it cost us under $1,000 or just on $1,000, it's definitely providing what it needs to provide. So if you enjoyed the video, guys, give us a big thumbs up and leave a comment down there if you've got any questions or even some tips for me. I'd love to hear them. So we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.